Hello, I'm Abiex, and welcome back to another Minecraft Update Aquatic video. Today I wanted to answer a pretty big and important question I know a lot of you have had about this update, because the aquatic update has obviously changed a lot of things to do with the water, such as drowns for instance, and it's changed the entire way that water physics have worked. So the big question is, has lava changed too? And the simple answer to that question is not so much, but the longer answer is that in a few different ways it sort of has. So I figured why not compare water and lava physics to see how much lava has changed, and also talk about a secret feature I found while performing these tests to see how they did work, because there is a secret feature that's a feature not found in the changelog that you probably didn't know about before that is in this update that's also version exclusive. So version exclusive secret feature, as well as a bunch more about lava. Hopefully you'll enjoy the video talking about and sharing some details about it. Like it if you do like it, because it helps out the channel. Let's know you do like to see these sorts of things about the aquatic update on the channel. So thank you for liking the video, but let's get straight into talking about the very first thing, you know, the lava water comparison. Because if you're curious as to like, has water changed, has lava changed in the same way that water has, you know, no longer the aquatic update, more like the volcanic update maybe, then the simple answer to the question is, in a lot of the basic ways you'd expect, no it hasn't. So one of the big ways is the fact that water can coexist alongside any other block in Minecraft, if it's a partial block, by kind of combining the two blocks together. So for instance, an anvil even, this is the weirdest looking one in my opinion, you can combine water and an anvil together because they can exist side by side in the same block. This isn't true for lava, however. If you try the exact same thing, you're like, oh, so we have a lava anvil? No, it just places it in front of the anvil. So you can use this in some interesting ways by like switching back and forth. You can have water be next to lava in a really, you know, kind of curious way by doing that. But the long story short on this is that no, you can't put you know, lava inside a thing, and you also can't replace water with lava by doing that. So there you go, fun fact number one is that lava does not have new physics to combine of blocks, but it does have an interesting new physics system when it comes to you know, like water, lava and being inside of it. So if you didn't know before this update and on every other platform, if you drink a fire resistance potion, one of these you know, nice things right here, and then you jump inside lava, you could stay in there indefinitely as long as you had that, you know, that effect on you, as I will have for the next 8 minutes. You could stay inside lava forever. However, in this update, the 1.4/1.5 update for Minecraft Bedrock, there is now a bubble meter. So I went back and checked, and on the Java and on the console, this definitely isn't the case. But as of the current aquatic update, they have changed lava in a significant way. One of the secret features inside this update is that lava will now drown. So that's right, the player character now has a different reaction to lava than it did before. It's more like water, because again, it uses the same bubble meter. It's not like a lava meter or anything, and everything else is fairly similar. But the fact that you can drown in it is really interesting, because it means that you can officially die just from going into lava, which is such a ridiculous thing when you really get down to it. Let me just show you that it does in fact choke you at the end here. And yeah, it's also, it has the same kind of like rebreathe function, where as soon as you go out, you can only breathe a bit by bit. But yeah, the same water and lava meter is kind of the same, which means it just, if you get out of water and then jump into some lava, you'll drown just as fast. So to prove that is a point right here, let me lose all of my oxygen in water. You know, like I can't breathe because I'm underwater. And guess what? I'm a Minecraft character, so I don't have gills or something. And then we've lost like 4 or 5 bubbles. And we hop straight into the lava. Oh, we a little bit too slow on that, but it's an easy thing to show that it's the exact same meter working in the exact same way with this exact same regen, because you can breathe as easily in water as you can in lava, which makes sense when you think about it, but it's still kind of wacky and interesting to see. So next up, let's talk about some other things to do with lava that do kind of change. So we're gonna scoop up our lava here and just take it with us, and let's go to the nether. So this is a really interesting one, because the nether has changed in a few ways to do with this aquatic update. Not necessarily the way lava functions itself, because again, lava has very, very similar functions before. But it is worth mentioning that lava flows slower on Bedrock, so another lava exclusive if we're on the same kind of thing. If you're into those sorts of things, then you'll know that lava in this update, in Bedrock in general, seems to spread a little bit slower than it does in other platforms. You can see that kind of much slower thing. It's whereas on other platforms it's more like water, on this platform it takes a little bit longer to really get anywhere, just like that. You can see it's a thing, and it's not really like you can use that in too many ways, and it's not like it's hugely slower, but you might be able to take advantage of that for something. And another thing you can take advantage of in this update is the fact that obviously fire resistance means you can swim through lava, but because now you take full damage and you can drown in lava, you don't want to fall in the sea even with these crazy potions, so just keep that in mind. But what you do want to do if you want to get yourself up and down is you want to jump into one of these lava columns. So I don't actually have a block. Oh, I do have a block to get back in. So we're going to build ourselves over to this just to prove it is there. It's probably going to burn, so we're going to be a little bit more careful about this. But if you want to get down and up in this update into the sort of thing, the best way to do so is to use this with fire resistance, and then you can kind of swim up it. So again, bear in mind, because it's a lava column, if you stay on the inside, you won't be able to breathe. But if you got the side of it, you can still breathe just like this. And this is a cool thing you can do in this update to take full advantage of it. It's super, super strange, but it is a thing we can now do. So next up, let's talk about out another interesting feature, because in this update, they added blue ice for the first time. So you're all probably aware of the fact that you obviously can't get ice properly working in the Nether. If you try, bad things happen. But you can get packed ice working, and you can also get blue ice working, and it's one of the most stunning blocks to have in the Nether. I think, given the color palette of the Nether, try putting blue ice with that, you're gonna have a good time. So, you know, water physics have changed a little bit in that, you know, a different type of water, the frozen variety works here. However, regular ice still won't produce water in this update, and even the bucket of pufferfish, or the bucket of any mob of your choice, will not produce the water alongside it. Like, again, it has the exact same effect as here, but you will be able to get the pufferfish out. So again, there's some really wacky edge case for this, which I'm gonna show you right now, because that's my favorite thing in Minecraft, right? Just weird edge case things. We're gonna take the pufferfish, and the pufferfish mob will be able to live in the Nether for a bit. So that's right, you can have fish in the Nether, and you can even kill them here if you want to. So again, there's some really weird situation where you might wanna bring the pufferfish with you, so you can kill it if you need to. But yeah, if I unload this onto the floor right now, you can see the fish survives like that. And then if we throw our splash potion at it, now it will survive lava, which means we can then put it in lava. And I really, really, oh geez, okay, don't poison me. Don't take out your pain on me. But you can actually, as you can see right here, you can actually put them inside the lava, but they don't treat it like it's water. Again, they're not like the player. They can't get their oxygen from it. They can't get a thing. And that's a really interesting thing they did with fish. They made them not only need to be inside a fluid, they have to be inside water. They can't be inside lava, as we've just proven right there. And also, you can get fish in the Nether. So yeah, there's the interesting thing that proves, and the reason I brought up all these things today, is because I think that it shows that in this update, you'd figure, you know, they changed water, so they must have changed lava too. And the truth is, they have changed lava a little bit, you know, that secret feature. And there's a few other things you'll see slowly through the update. But the truth is, in this update, water went from being just lava that doesn't hurt you and that can, you know, move you faster and stuff like that, to being an entirely different kind of thing. The fact that water has, you know, air that can be breathed by fish in there, but, you know, lava does not. The fact that these two things are getting further and further apart goes to show that Minecraft does not see the two fluids as being the same thing. And, you know, part of me says, you know, looking at that, maybe there's room for more fluids in the future. If we're gonna leave a, you know, water and lava being so different, why not have a third different one? Like, if we have the, you know, they have the tools clearly to have very different properties for very different things, so maybe we'll see something in the future. And my favorite one, this is just speculation at this point, wouldn't it be cool if we had milk buckets that you could physically place down, and then it would be like, you know, curing poison water? Boom, there's an idea. Hope you all enjoyed the video though. Hope you enjoyed the secret feature, as well as learning about the pufferfish and the water thing. Let me know you liked it with a like, and also let me know what sorts of fluids you think you would like to see in Minecraft, because again, the only idea I have is, like, you know, I'd love to see milk buckets, but if you have a better one than milk in Minecraft, which I'm sure you probably do, I'd love to hear it in the comments down below. And for now, I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all later for Store Sunday. Have a nice day. Goodbye.